Jessica looking for her cash.
You found it, Jess?
Newman Rocks.
You having fun there, Layla?
Way to Esperance from Norseman. We had to make a decision between spending 7 days in Kalgoorlie Boulder or spreading the load out and spending some time. Yeah. Spending some time in Esperance and spend all going down to Wave Rock. And eventually we decided to hit the beach, grab some coffees, grab some dinners out.
In Esperance, Esperance style.
Esperance it up. So I'll probably spend 2 to 3 nights here and then head up to Kalgoorlie where we've got to get some bits and pieces from Toyota, get some new trailer plugs, do a few little repairs on the car, get a tyre changed over.
Get some supplies.
Do a Woolworths shop, yep. And then get on to the Anne Beadell. So we don't know whether we'll stay in Kalgoorlie and then go straight to the Anne Beadell, or whether we'll go through to Leonora and spend the night in lovely old Leonora before we hit Anne Beadell. The only thing that I can guarantee is we will not stay in Laverton the night before we go to the Anne Beadell. That will never happen.
So the water's gonna come in here. It's pulled up here. There's a bit of a dam at the start. All the way up. And Layla will stand in the hole to get her feet wet. There it is! There it is! Yeah. How's she gonna get up? She doesn't know. Leave her. Go!
Now!
Esperance was a lovely town and we were really enjoying it so much that we decided to add on a couple of nights to our stay.
Picks the right tool. Sometimes she describes it and passes it to Brett, who then finds out how to use it. Layla! One of my favourite things about Esperance is the bell.
So here in Kalgoorlie, and we're just getting ready to head on home, back down the Anne Beadell and up north of Ilkirka through Blackstone. Got our shopping out here, just getting everything put away and organised. Looks like a bit of a mess. The jerry cans are on the roof, the car is in tip-top shape. We've got a new tyre put on the back. One of the coopers started cracking around the edge of the bead, around this part here. It had started to crack. It was on the front right, so Pa rang Terry Smith from Cooper's Tyres, and Terry made sure the boys in Kalgoorlie were very good to us, and they were, and they swapped them over. And we also got a wheel alignment. The other thing that we've attempted this time is I've put on Armorald spray. You can see the frosting in the window of the van. It's a clear coat that's gonna try and get over the scratch, that's just meant to stop scratches and that kind of thing. So one of the things that we're gonna try is we've got no room left in our fridge. We've got a fair bit of room left in our freezer. So I'm gonna try freezing drink bottles in here every day and then rotating them into a fruit and veg bag that we've got down here and see if that can help us keep our fruit and veg a bit. Here we are. Gonna try and rotate them into here with our fruit and veg and see if we can't keep our fruit and veg a bit crisper for a bit longer. So, we'll we'll see how that goes.
So after a little bit of driving around in maybe one circle, we found the way off the Anne Beadell Highway.
We left Laverton quite late and we got a little bit caught out as the first few stations that you come through bait for dogs and a couple have no camping signs.
Binda is keenly looking out to the front here. A few kilometres back we had the window down showing Layla a whole heap of cows that were going past, and he was just about to leap out of that little tiny space there, out and out the window to the cows. He was very keen. Hello, Layla. Say hello. It's very bright when you look at mummy. Since we've pulled up, Layla has not stopped playing in the sand. She is loving the red sand.
Me and Layla are just packing up camp. Only got a little bit to go, close it up, get the dog in. Jessica and Binda have gone for a run. So out of camp, 100 k's out of Laverton. Pretty ugly camp, millions of ants.
We are at Yeo, Lake Yeo Homestead.
29th of October 2014, heading east to Ilkoka, then due north to Blackstone and home to Docker River. Brett, Jess and Layla, 18 months old, with two dogs, T-Van and Prado.
Well done. And Layla is still running around.
The start of the Anne Beadell Highway is really quite fast. We were sitting on between 60, 80 and occasionally up to 90. We found ourselves at Lake Yeo Homestead in no time at all, and it was a really well maintained homestead. Parks have put a little bit of money and effort into keeping it in mint condition, and Layla enjoyed running around and checking it all out as we did.
Layla's washing her face. A quick climb up here. Brett, Layla and the dogs are in the car. Oh, holes in the rocks. Good. Oh.
While Jess was off doing something productive, I'd managed to find myself bored enough to do something completely unproductive, and in the end, a little bit silly. As I was coming back down the hill, the wheels were locking up, and I was just sliding at times in a free fall backwards, so it was not the best situation we'd been on that far in the trip.
Hard driving by any means.
No, it's reflected in the the fuel consumption that the computer's reading, 16.8. When we got to Neil Junction, travelling along the Konisu, what was it like in the 20s? 22? Yeah. 21?
Yeah.
Yeah, so a lot, like over 5 litres per 100 less. What's just happened?
Oh, somewhere. And Ben did a shit. That was Ben's shit.
Was it at the pool?
Oh. And I picked it up. Stashed it away here with a gas bottle.
I reckon it was out of the pool before we left.
So it's a few days old and it's been sitting there in this black tarp, just getting...
In the heat of the day.
And I just smelt it, and oh my god, it is disgusting.
Well, I was almost vomiting. It's the worst thing you ever smelt, you said.
Oh,
and Binda ran over to investigate.
It's not as bad as those camels, but it's in the same category. Like, if those dead camels were a cat one, that was in cat one.
And we've actually been smelling something a bit...
dead.
...unusual in the car, thinking Layla's got a poo in her nappy, like, all day today. But no, nothing.
Maybe it was
coming from the tea pan. Ben hates storms. He's having a freak out. He's now in here. So we're stuck again. Don't know if you saw that. A little bit of a thing that we're having trouble with is Ben's now in my seat. Is that when we're coming over the top of the sand dune, that looks quite steep and we just don't want to drive over a drop off. But the trailer is still behind on the other side and it's not over the sand hill yet, so that's what's happened here is we've slowed down to check the drop off and didn't carry enough speed to get the trailer over. So just gotta let the tires down because can't go forward or back. Anyway, so that lightning's getting closer and closer. Brett's just trying to rock the car. But not getting anything. Well, I reckon we're getting them a little bit better. Huh? Oh, we got it. Feel better?
That's hard work, Layla.
Finish jump.
French line, here we come.
Yeah, French line training. We'll just keep coming down here every now and then. That storm snow over there seems to be on the other side of us now, but it's pretty close. Pretty scary, you know, metal car on top of a sand dune. Well, not when you're in it, more so when you're beside it.
We're going to see the plane, Layla.
Layla had a bit of a crash this morning. Summer. Didn't you? Can you see the plane, Layla? Have a look out the window for the plane. We're looking for a plane on the ground that crashed.
Where is it? Can you see a plane? I can see one out there. No, try looking out there. We can hop out now and we're gonna get wet.
Gonna get a little bit wet.
This is where we were stuck before. You can see it was raining and there's a dry patch where we were. So we're here at Ilkirka. Roadhouse is just over there. We've been having some battery issues with the camera, so I didn't do any recording. This is a campground. How many tanks have they put up? Water tanks?
10 water ships?
Yeah, 10 water tanks that they've put up about the region. She has to travel into there's one lady here at the moment. She's had, 17 people come through in October?
Yep, 17 white fellas.
Yeah, white fellas, that's probably a key fact, statistic. And she goes into Kalgoorlie every 2 to 3 months for supplies. So she's obviously not eating very fresh food. If she needs, she has to go into Dundundjaro for anything else. It's about 10 hours to Kalgoorlie, across to Neil Junction, down Conithuin, along the railway access line. And apparently she said that it's about 6 hours to Blackstone if you know the road north.
Sandhilly and a lot of big sandhills with a little swale in between, and then another sandhill we kind of have to climb up a little bit to go down. So it's been interesting and fun driving the first 6.1 kilometres down the road.
And how many sandhills are we up to?
12. So we're about 30 k's down. And there's a bit of water on the track, so they must have had some more substantial rain through here. And with dark, ominous clouds around us, could this turn into an epic adventure? Maybe it's lucky that we got an extra 20 litres of fuel than what I was hoping to get at Ilkirka.
At $3.
At $3 a litre. Jessica in the driver's seat. Driving through the rain once again.
The rain's coming through the
air. We're about 50 kilometres out from the Ilkirka Roadhouse, just searching for our night's camp.
we're driving down the road, obviously, and it's been really quite wet here. I'm just saying, you wouldn't want another 20 mil on there and have to drive through there immediately. Like, it wouldn't take long, obviously, for it to dry out, but the road is starting to get wet. It's meant to be another storm tonight, which shouldn't cause us too much problems, but who knows? Well, at the end of the day, it's nice to have a good feed. Tonight we're having creamy pesto chicken pasta. Last night at 9 o'clock, Jess was just reminiscing. There was a small two-wheel drive go past us. So they've
From north to south. Yeah.
So they've pushed through all this at night time in their little car. We're about a third of the way down the track. We've passed one car that's been abandoned, and there's another one. One thing that's very interesting about, to me, is really interesting about the cars out here is we've passed three, two have been unburnt, and one's been burnt. So I don't know if the mob are taking this track a little bit more seriously in the remoteness of it and thinking, well, we actually need spare parts on this road. So we're coming up to a big herd of camels.
Camels are famous for running along tracks. Go around them, but oh, there's more up here.
There's a massive one just through here.
The black one?
Yeah.
Move!
Layla just told them to move, and a whole heap of them headed off into the bushes.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, I can't count them. What?
So we're 2 hours into the day, and how many kilometres have we come?
86.
86?
Yeah, what?
Oh, I thought we were averaging a lot higher speeds than that.
So have I.
We're just about probably 20 minutes off a Y intersection to choose between Docker River and Irindu. Don't really know which one we're going to take. We hope to take the Blackstone one, but all the broken down cars have got South Australian number plates on them, so I'm thinking that the road's more used by the Pip and Kalka mob and Irindu, perhaps. However, there's a chance that the tracks that will join up behind Blackstone might be used for hunting and going out bush and that kind of stuff. So even though they mightn't come down here, the track might still be relatively well used. Any pearls of wisdom, Jessica?
Not for free. Well,
Mole, that is a pearl of wisdom. About what?
This.
I knew it was coming. What just happened, Jess? So what the long story was, these are the breakaways, and Jess said to me, oh, we can't see them.
Oh, like, look.
And I'm like, oh, we'll come up to them closer, further on. And then she's like, oh, what, we're going to drive over the breakaways? She didn't believe me that the contour lines would outline the breakaways and where they're
at. Not necessarily.
Not necessarily, but did they?
Yes.
So your punishment, I'm thinking, will be a public execution. Just making our way back down to the car. Jessica making her way downhill. It's a fairly steep climb. We overshot the Blackstone Road, so we've had to do a quick little turnaround and come back. I'll be very interested to see if the Blackstone Road here is as well used as the Irringi Road. Some sticks across the road there. Is that symbolic? It's 1:13 now and we left camp at 9 o'clock. The Blackstone Road is
9:30.
Blackstone Road is nowhere near as maintained as the other road and well used. However, at the moment, isn't proving too difficult. Jess is sitting on about 30 kilometres an hour now. I think that's about as fast as we'll go.
So this is what we were referring to about Prado's good advantage over a 200 series is its width. This is a reason why width is important. We do this sort of stuff a fair bit, really. And he's also got a new seat in an effort to save some time, do a bit quicker, easier.
This is called an open plane. It's a nice change up from what we've been experiencing. We're about 5-6 minutes off the intersection at this speed. Well, not the intersection, it's a Y section, which we're hoping gets a lot, the track gets a lot better.
So Brett's just sawed that tree over. We're just talking about how we think that getting a pair of secateurs would be good for the car for this sort of stuff. Daddy's gonna try and get that tree down. Whoa! Go, Daddy! Half the tree fell down! Timber!
That's just Tim.
Timber! Yeah! There's the hacksawra, whatever you call them. Timberjack.
Tree or
lumberjack.
I am a lumberjack after doing that.
Look at that. Whoa, that's a good foot there for the tree. Yep.
The track has not really got much better. Slow going. This is quite a fast section, between 15 to 20 kilometres an hour. In 48 kilometres from the start of this track, we hit a wind section. So I'm hoping up there, this track starts to see a bit more traffic and gets a bit better.
We hooked on 111 and it's now 124.
So I've done 13 kilometres out of that 43. So just over a quarter done.
Impending doom.
It's getting quite windy. And if we take a zoom down the road,
but we'll be getting out.
It's not much fun. Starting to get a bit wet the road. It's just started hailing. Occasionally you'll see little bits of hail. And the road is filling up with water.
Brett's just told me to come have a look at the trailer park. You can see that the inverter has fallen off the wall. It should be up there. You can see that's broken off on the top and on the bottom, so it's not going to stick on the wall anymore, but we'll have to find somewhere secure for it. But luckily the impact of it falling off didn't affect its performance. It's coming out to give you a kiss. Good catching, Debbie. We've just found a well. So we'll go over and try and pump some. It's working. So Brett needs to go to the top to do some maintenance.
Out in the distance, we can see some big ranges forming. Starting to get back into the area of the desert that we're used to. It's been pretty flat through Spinifex country, and what features there have been quite small. Not unimpressive, but definitely not the magnitudes of the Nundara native tidal area and the Docker River area. Got Peak Hill out to the side. We're not having any tree problems. It's nice.
It's fine.
So around half the track was a pretty big effort. Now it's paying dividends. We're just smooth sailing straight towards Docker River. Jess has Blackstone. Docker River could still be an epic adventure away. Jess has all the sails up on the tall mast and the small mast. So we've just come across an outstation. Over here is the windmill, which looks pretty well maintained, and two pretty nice buildings, I reckon.
Suffered some damage to the tyre.
We've blown yet another fuse while I was trying to pump up the tyres. I quickly come to the realisation that it wasn't. It was the air compressor, obviously, that's throwing the fuses. And then on a quick investigation, I realised that the ARB air compressor has a 40 amp fuse on it, compared to the car, which had previously, on the Anderson plug, had a 25 amp fuse, and now and then I put in a 30 amp fuse, which still blew. So I hooked up to the
T-Van Anderson plug, which also has a 30 amp fuse, and just hoped it got me there, which it did. So when I get home, I need to investigate whether the wire can handle 40 amps and upgrade the fuse accordingly, or whether I need to run a new line if I want to keep it on the Anderson plug. Jess is around here making some lunch. We got the fortunate news that we can travel home the way we want to. So we should only be a few hours away from home. In the spirit of adventure, we've taken a bit of a detour home. We're not on the main road that runs from Blackstone to Yirrindju.
Brad doesn't believe that I was bogged. He's just trying some rocking technique. Another Beadell marker. So, just joining up to the Great Central Road. We've got apparently 54 kilometres left in the tank, and I think there's about 26. Roughly about 66 kilometres to Docker River. So
might be putting some fuel in.
Yeah, but we're just seeing. Who knows? Just a little bit of drama to finish a trip with. And we're nearly home.
Almost over.
Layla's sleeping the last little bit of holiday. She's over it. Oh. We've not long ago passed a sign that said it was 30 km to Warrakoona, which means it's that we're about 70 km from home, and we had 44 km left in, so we thought while Layla was still asleep we should stop and put a jerry can in.
Much more pleasant without a screaming kid.
Yeah.
Minmar Kultara on the horizon marked the end of our 3-week desert adventure and signalled to us that we're getting nice and close to our hometown of Docker River.